Welcome to our talk. It's titled, "Hey Bro, You Got a Lighter? I Need to Do Some Electroporation." So the first warning is, on the DEF CON website, it's mentioned that it's like about a bioweapon under the description. That is not what this talk is about. I don't know why it didn't get fixed, but so we'll start with saying that this device that we're about ready to show you should not be used as a bioweapon. Okay, cool. Moving on. All right, so for those that don't know me, my name is Dr. James Utley. I have a PhD in health science. I do kind of a lot of things in the bio, so I guess I'm a biohacker doubling as a professional scientist. And I'll just go through this real quick so you know that I'm not some yahoo that doesn't know what he's kind of talking about. But I think that title of being a yahoo is kind of cooler anyway. So anyway, first off is I have the honor and the privilege of being a chief scientific officer at a regenerative medicine stem cell clinic in Panama, which where I live. So woo, go Origins. That's my day job. We're flying today under the flag of Viva Securus, which is myself, Phil Rhodes, and Josh Hill, otherwise known as the Post-6 Ninja. He couldn't make it here today, but he is a mystical creature that has fueled some of the greatness behind our company, for sure. And then lastly, is I have folks here from a biohacker collective we have here in Las Vegas called Syndicate Laboratories. It's a homage to the YT Cracker album for any of those that didn't get that. Anyway, so Phil is the master of many talents here. Pen tester, and I don't know if there is truly like this find a fed type, but anyway, here's one, meaning he's in the Navy, so go Navy. All right, so yeah, you can grab the contacts there from the QR. Hopefully people can get them, yeah. All right, moving on, let's get into, I want to apologize in advance. Like, I don't mean to offend anyone here on this this talk of like what we're gonna, you know, but it has been infected with like dad jokes and just some fuckery. And so be warned, if you want me to say earmuffs beforehand, I can, but when we're making this, we're thinking like, hey, are we overusing memes? And then we're like, no, let's just go with it, right? And so you'll see. Anyway, moving on. So this is where we're gonna start. So where this all started here is is from an electro pen, right? So you see some of these like university students here that put together an electroporation device, and we'll kind of get into, like, we're trying to keep this talk like very kind of simple and easy to digest. And so, but anyway, this is where it started. And these college kids did a great job of like really taking this barbecue lighter and then electroporating transfecting some DNA from extracellular to inside the cell. And that's what this talk is we took their study and we made the next, I mean, basically it's an easier device to assemble in my opinion. But the key take home point here is that we want to stress that like there's the potential to democratize science using frugal tools. And that's really what kind of this whole thing is about, is that you, the people, can learn about these techniques, whether it's genetic engineering, whether it's, you know, science in general, however you like, and be able to learn it from the comfort of your own home. Anyway, moving on. And yeah, I guess I kind of started that. I started my rant already, right? So we just like, you know, the access to electroporation technology or genetic engineering that you can, you know, the sky's the limit, and, you know, and kind of like, what is your imagination and how to, you know, transfect cells or genetic engineering. And this is just one way to do it. And it allows that like the people can then, you know, identify like what, you know, that they have the skills and the resources and the know-how to do these type of experiments. And it doesn't have to be confined by fancy instruments or, you know, big pharma or, you know, or academia just kind of like locking it up. You know, science is for everyone. So this is just one example. Now, some of this stuff is already done in biohacker labs that are, you know, out throughout the community. And, you know, I really appreciate that community, and that's why I try to invest my time and my effort into the biohacker community, meaning like the genetic engineer, DIY bio, those folks, because it's important. I've noticed over like the last 5 years that they just become like less, I guess maybe less organized or maybe less prevalent. And so if you have a curiosity for science, then, you know, find a community and join it. So for sure. Okay, now this is a little bit of the detour here, but it's all in the same route. So bear with me here. Transfection is actually what we're trying to do through electroporation. So we're trying to use electricity to develop a pore in a cell to then insert from an extracellular, maybe that's a DNA or RNA, into the cell to hijack the machinery and or express a different protein. Now, because I am a big Nicolas Cage fan, and I like the fact of electroporation, this presentation has been transfected with Nicolas Cage memes. And so if you see, it's a process used in genetic engineering, you know, from foreign into the cell. So the challenge is here, when we get to the end, that there is a number of Nicolas Cage memes and or references and or and I'll give you one hard one, but at the end we'll see if every, you know, we have a last slide here that we can see how many Nicolas Cage references we have seen. And I will also agree that Nicolas Cage's face on things is the best thing I've ever looked up. So, oh, okay, all right. And again, I'm sorry that you chose this session, because there's some terrible memes and dad jokes. Anyway, so how this all started for me personally is that I realized from that paper that you could use a lighter it's not for smoking, it's for electroporation. And so I wrote this like really cringy type Substack post some years ago. And with that, we're like, okay, well, let's see if we can fucking do this thing for real. And that's where it kind of all started. So welcome to the BioVolt Revolution. You didn't know that you were attending this talk. And it's a low-cost portable electroporator, which just means it's a barbecue lighter. And maybe Phil, you want to show like what the device looks like? And it's inspired by a barbecue lighter, or the PZT, or the piezoelectric effect of a lighter to start a barbecue. And it's meant to bring synthetic biology to the masses. Okay, so electroporation 101. And I'm sorry I'm going through this fast, because we only have a limited amount of time. So it's a technique to deliver molecules, DNA, into cells, right? And it uses electropulses, right, which is the clicking of the lighter, to create a pore, which then it will enter. So sometimes when you're trying to select what you want to electroporate or transinfect, you get kind of confused, like, what's right, DNA, RNA, or whatever. But that's part of the journey here, because this is really part one of really three phases of a project. Part one meaning that this is the tool, and we're going to try to show you how we can provide some reproducibility on the tool to electroporate or add. And then step two is really the plasmid selection, like what do you want to put inside the cell? And then the last part is like recovery and counting, which we'll kind of gloss over at the end. Okay. Electroporation 101. So the first thing to start with is it's not easy. It's really difficult to do it in a DIY environment. It is really difficult. And so it's really carefully hinged on parameters, like optimizing those parameters, which means like the gap, the amount of trigger, the pulse, and those type of things. And so the electric field, the ionic composition of the fluid in which you're putting your DNA with to transfect the cells in which you have chosen. So it's actually really difficult. So if you take this home and you want to do it, just know that it's very, very hard. But it's not possible. And you see here, I have like a little picture of the cuvette, we call it the cuvette, and it has a microfluidic well, which you kind of developed. And through the pulsing, it provides some electricity. And that's that, right? So again, we're going to talk about We're going to talk about how we're taking a nucleic acid sequence and we're trying to take it from extracellular and put it inside the cell. And I will, this is my the freebie here. If you look at the nucleus of this meme here, nucleus cage, I don't know. Hopefully somebody finds that funny. Moving on. Okay, so another breakdown here. You know, you have like this plasmid, right? So you have like your fluid in which you're, and I guess I should say that PBS or phosphate buffered saline is really good. And you wanna you wanna add your DNA in which you've chosen, right? With this, with your cells and give it a good pulse, you'll see on the right-hand side. And by doing so, it opens up a pore and that plasmid will then become intracellular. That's the ultimate goal. That's what you're trying to do. And yeah. So why are we doing this? Why are we doing this is because, you know, we're all part banana and some of us are part, you know, if you ever, and the broader point is that if you want to learn about this, to make yourself a Nicolas Cage hybrid banana, like you should be able to, right? Nobody should tell you you can't do that. So, you know, that's the essence there. Okay, so spoiler alert, the device is really ugly. And you'll see on the left-hand side of the slide there, you see it's just a barbecue lighter and it has the trigger, which is the PZT effect. And we've kind of like optimized it. And if you were ever wanted to look back at the college kids that did this before, they 3D printed this nice housing environment that had some wires that kind of delivered. But it was definitely difficult to make contact with the cuvette. And really it's about like the consistency of the fluid, the microfluidic well or a channel, if you will, and the cuvette that really kind of makes the difference. You'll see some other equipment. Of course, this is a pipette. And then on the right-hand side, there was like some crazy ideas like, okay, if I'm gonna put I'm gonna try to have it migrate down a microfluidic well and then kind of aggregate there and then zap it there. No, did not really work because it just killed cells, which we'll talk about later. Okay, moving on. Because it's so ugly, you know, maybe it's the greatest threat to world peace. Okay, light, laugh, no? Okay, all right, we're moving on. We had this like running joke about this full body electroporation. I don't know if this movie is gonna give us, if this will give us sounds. But it's like, okay, okay. And there's no sound, but you can outplay as Luigi. Again, I already apologized up front. Okay, yeah, but back to it. Yes, this is still a very ugly device. And, but it's cheap. That's the part. It's cheap to make and you can make it at your home. It's very crude. And you can get all these items here. I don't know, Phil. Let's see, we don't have the heat shrink wire insulator, but that's like duct tape or electrical tape. The aluminum tape is kind of a conductive material that you want to put over the magnets. There's a roll of adhesive magnets there that we kind of stack, and that kind of makes that field. And then you have the aluminum overlay that kind of is a conductive material to make the cuvette. And then there's like 9-volt battery kind of a, and it doesn't travel very well, I'll say that. They're kind of wondering, like, what the fuck is that? Because I live in Panama, I had to travel here, so. Anyway, so we made some more devices when we got back. But it's definitely cheaper than, and we'll see if this lands. We'll see if this joke lands. It's definitely than the $10 Uber Eats card you received because of the CrowdStrike Windows outage. Nobody? Yeah, okay, good. It landed. Yeah. It already expired? Wow. Okay, so I'm glad the joke landed there, because, yeah. Okay, again, I guess we kind of talked on this. So the one point here on this slide is this smart glass biointerface, which is a really cool name for a microscope slide. They seem to work well when you're trying to develop the arc gap. So yeah, just a standard microscope. Okay, and you know, as so the point here is to kind of like iterate on, do you know, find crazy devices, and as long as you can insert this PZT crystal or the piezoelectric crystal effect, then you could essentially make it an electroporator. And I was using super glue to like develop part of the device, and I was like, hey, you know what? I'm gonna use this like super glue casing to make another one. And I put a little washer there, and then that red cap became like the spring, and I was like, okay, this will do it, you know? Anyway, the point is like, you know, use your imagination. But the pro tip is that the Bic lighters, they suck. You know, they're probably great lighters, but when you're trying to do that, trying to make an electroporator from the device, they suck. They suck so bad that we took apart two and we're like, okay, can we put this thing, you know, make it a device? And then we're like, I don't think so. And then we were so genius that we're like, you know what we should need to do? We need to get another one and fail for the third time. And we did in that. So pro tip, Bic lighters suck. Again, you know, I've like talked about this, like it's the power of the voltage, the piezoelectric effect from the crystal here, right? And it's you'll see this next couple slides of how firing is an important. I took this one of the words from the college kids that first did this electro pen, and they said it was very reliable, you know, and I'm like, okay, so there's fair reproducibility, which we'll get into. But that's it. You're trying to get over around this like 2000 volts. This is actually a little close. Whoa, extreme close up. Okay. Well, here's another aspect or an important part of the assembly here, which is the cuvette, or we were calling it earlier, the bio interface. And it's, if you show that fill, you'll see that it's aluminum tape wrapped around it, some adhesive magnets on top of some glass. Pretty crude, pretty awesome. And in the center picture here, these are kind of like some weird configurations. I was like, hey, you know what? Let's try to adjust the arc gap, which you'll see, or let's try to develop a well. Let's see what works the best. You know, they were trying to contain me, but in a cage made of Nicholas. And this is the arc gap, which I think I'd say at this, when you're developing this device or building this device, that actually is kind of the most important part. And it is, size does matter. So most of the literature around electroporation on like a no shit commercial device is around the 1 millimeter arc gap. So you see that, but we used two really scientific indexes to kind of mess with the gap. The first one being the post-it note index. So if you take the post-it notes at around 10 or 5 and fold them in half, it gives you kind of a start. But then we're like, hey, you know what, this is Vegas and we need another method, which is the playing card index. So if you start with 5 playing cards, gives you that nice gap, but if you want to extend it out to 2 millimeters, just add an extra playing card before, as you're developing this. The point is, you know, try it, you know, mess with it, because it is important on zapping these cells. And what lighter is the best? We found that it's the Scripto Aim and Flame. It's fire. Yes. Follow them on Facebook. All right. Now, this is where myself and Phil decided to get a little crazy in terms of testing. We wanted to look at what these college kids did in their study, and then it's like, hey, let's see if we can kind of reproduce something or provide some scientific value to this. And, but as it says on the slide, I'm not a crystal wizard or an electrician. So, you know, but the short of it is, we zapped this thing with a high voltage multimeter, and we were getting some reproducibility, but it looks like we have each fire is 2 seconds in between, and then we waited 2 minutes. And if you can see that, you know, you don't have to be a genius to see kind of a pattern here that 2 clicks is good, then it drops off, right? So it kind of decays, which has some correlation with what's on the left-hand side, even though there's a lot of different lighters here and this voltage curve, which anyway, so there's some reproducibility is the point. Moving on, here's the raw data, so you know that it's not just a terrible color chart. And then we have this other setting on the multimeter called resistance. And again, We're not crystal wizards or electricians. So we're like, hey, let's try to hook this thing up and see what the resistance looks like, meaning that we can provide reproducibility. And sure enough, we did. It has this nice curve there. So, because we're trying to answer the question, is this device, does it have some reliability that then you can control the other variables to actually get the DNA or the RNA inside the cell? And so we're saying yes. All right, now we're gonna play this video real quick because I'm running out of time. And this is my office here in Panama, in my little biohacker lab. Anyway, here's the device. Phil shows it. It's a click, click, click. I'm gonna fast forward here just a little bit. And then you hook that guy up, the cuvette. And if you really want to, well, again, it's hard to do and there's a lot of trial and error, but you can kind of pre-chill that cuvette. So then when you add in your plasmid or your electrocompetent cells, then it you're trying to reduce the amount of cell death that you're the creator of death of cells. All right, so we're gonna, yeah, okay, that's where you're gonna put the fluid, the stuff, the DNA, the cells, and the phosphate buffered saline. And while I'm going through this, I also have a little note card because there was things I didn't want to miss around this part, which is there's a recommended 2.5 microliters of DNA. Like that's kind of the max. If you do more of that in terms of plasma generation, it's not very efficient. You can use PBS and or sterile water, but if you have like contaminants, then it kind of messes with it'll mess with the electroporation transformation effect. You're gonna kill a lot of cells. So this is, on this video, this is where I'm providing the inoculum or the plasmid in through the microfluidic well, and then I'm gonna buzz it. Okay, good, video over. But the take home point here is to make sure that you know that you're gonna be killing a lot of cells. So, and that's just the nature of electroporation. I think the literature supports that like between 50 and 70% of cells are destroyed in this process on these with electroporator devices. But you're going to, because these, it's kind of more uncontrolled, if you will, you're gonna provide a lot of cell death. Okay, so transformation. What are some things that you can test this guy on? You can use E. coli, electrocompetent E. coli is very, so in terms of electroporation or transfection, it's easier to do. We had talked about some yeast, and then me, as of course, being a stem cell scientist, I was like, okay, well, let's hit it up with some stem cells. Now, let's see the reporter marker, if you will. It's really good for the green fluorescent protein or the superfolding green fluorescent protein, is because when you incubate them, then you can see it on the back end. Anyway, we're gonna. You'll see this is electroporator device here on the slide here, and of course Nicolas Cage is always trying to reinvent himself, obviously. Now we're getting to the last part here. So this is kind of after we're not talking about the tool, but we're talking about the protocol for cloning. You can see in this nice meme here that when you've already transformed your cells using this commercial electroporator, and then of course this barbecue lighter that we have here. Then you look at the colonies and you're like, okay, there's no colonies. And then you have no idea what went wrong, and then you cry, and then you repeat it and you adjust. And that's the whole thing about science. You know, you just kind of have to adjust the parameters to get it right on. And if you do so, you can cross the Holy Grail and make your Nicolas Cage banana hybrid. And the cell recovery is a really tough thing, which I think we're like running out of time on that one. But here's a short little picture of and this took many iterations, but if you see, and I'm glad I took a good picture of this, even though not so good, you see there's kind of this wave of these tiny little colonies. Those graciously were conducted via the BioVolt or the electroporator pen, yeah. Okay, troubleshooting. Now, the troubleshooting is, of course, I have talked about, there's a lot of cell death. You are the destroyer of worlds when it comes to this. A lot of cells are going to die, but all you need is a small portion to grow, and then you're like, okay, mission complete. The excessive arcing, remember some of the two methods that we said, you know, use the the playing card index is really great. I actually like that one a lot. But you can adjust the arc, and then, but you should keep in mind that despite whatever prior studies or even around electroporators, that it has low efficiency, meaning like it doesn't work all the fucking time. So you just got to know that going into it. If you want the protocol, you can choose your adventure here. One of these will lead you to an access point where we could provide a protocol to have one build and whatever else, but it, so have a look-see. And then where's my goon? Am I good on time still? Yeah. Okay. Good. Yeah. Okay. Cool. All right. And now we move to the key of cage. And we will pause here. Oh, uno minuto? Yeah, okay, we're at 1 minute. And so if anybody have a guess how many memes we got? Nicolas Cage memes? Send it, go ahead. 12? That's 12. Yeah, no, there is more than that. There is, who got it? He's the guy right there. Because we put 20 here, it's kind of like a ruse. And then there was that extra one, which you must have been scanning QR codes. Congratulations. Okay, well. Yeah, we have something for you. Okay, well, that is our talk. It was brief, but remember, this is tool one of a electroporating journey. I hope people try it. You know, the biohacking community, if you have an inclination for science, then, you know, please reach out to one of us. And again, we fly under the flag of Viva Securus, which is actually a medical device pen testing company. And then this last is, you know, remember, please don't do coke in the bathroom. This is a real sign somewhere in the world for all you OSINT folks. You can go find it. Thank you.